Apparently, breaking news from the Guardian, the Trump campaign has filed a lawsuit to halt the counting of votes in Michigan. Gee, I wonder why, because it's going against him, as we knew that it would. They filed a lawsuit to halt the counting. There's a message from Bill Stepien, campaign manager for Donald Trump, saying President Trump's campaign has not been provided with meaningful access to numerous counting locations to observe the opening of ballots and the counting process as guaranteed by Michigan law. We have filed suit today in the Michigan Court of Claims to halt counting until meaningful access has been granted. We also demand to review those ballots which were opened and counted while we did not have meaningful access. President Trump is committed to ensuring that all legal votes are counted in Michigan and everywhere else. And so they have done this, of course, because Trump is now losing Michigan, and it is likely that he will lose Michigan if all the votes are counted. They have no interest in that happening, and we will now have to see. You know what? The dice have been cast. Do we have a democracy, or can they use their baked-in Supreme Court supermajority to just decide the results for whatever state they need to win an election? Michigan is going to be one ground zero for that. We're also probably going to have Pennsylvania soon. But JR, things have gotten exciting in the exact way that we predicted they would.
Absolutely, I'm going to say it's sticking with the same thing we're talking about. It's exactly what was planned. It's the whole idea. This is what they're supposed to do. So these are the steps on the ladder to take you to that final moment of, yeah, we're just gonna go ahead and say it's us. They have to have something they refer to once they get to that end point to be like, well, there was that one legal battle. We filed a lawsuit in Michigan for them to stop counting votes because they were totally trying to screw us over. You're gonna find 15 different excuses as to why they're being screwed over in the next half a week. And hopefully they're gonna stretch this for their point of view, hopefully. They're gonna stretch this for months.
Yeah, I'm seeing like right now Biden's lead in Michigan has grown to 34,000 votes. That's about three times larger than Trump's victory there. I think it's actually a little bit more than that now. And again, that doesn't necessarily mean anything. Only the final count matters. But it is looking like this is not going to be as close as it was back in 2016 when Trump actually won in the state. And so they can't have it because they absolutely have to win there. I mean, I'm trying to find as much information as we're going, but
again, like I was saying, the new campaign slogan is stop the votes, stop counting votes, 2020. Mike Pence, Donald Trump, stop the vote, stop democracy, 2020. Throw that on your bumper sticker, throw it on your flag next to Make America Great Again. Stop the vote.
Yeah, and they all agree. They all agree. You know, even so, Ben Shapiro had his little tweet that like, I think democracy is okay or whatever, effectively is what he said. Okay, now let's get to the specifics. Do they get to stop the count in Michigan? We'll see if Ben Shapiro has anything to say about that. When they try to not count a million votes in Pennsylvania, is that okay? Well, we'll see in the specifics if he's actually gonna stick to his kind of guns. I have a feeling not. And certainly Fox News is gonna be totally fine with all this.
Ask every elected Republican that. Every time they stick their head out of a hole, ask them, do you agree with the Trump administration, Trump campaigns push to not count votes? Do you believe in not counting all the votes of the American people? Do you what do you have against the American people? Just ask them all the questions, because these aren't gotcha or unfair questions. This is exactly who you're supporting. This is what he's doing. Do you support him? We're not moving on until you answer.
Yeah, you know though, I'm gonna give 1% credit, kind of, to acknowledging reality too. Scott Walker, remember, I don't want to throw Cenk under the bus. Didn't Cenk think Scott Walker had a good chance? Was it Scott Walker that he thought had a good chance
in the primary
2016?
Less, I don't think so.
Maybe Scott I'm Walker wrong. I'm probably remembering that wrong. Oh, it might have been Rand Paul. Anyway, it don't matter. They're gonna do the recount in Wisconsin. Right now, Biden is up by like 20,600 votes or so. So Scott Walker tweeted, after recount in 2011 race for Wisconsin Supreme Court, there was a swing of 300 votes. After recount in 2016 presidential race in Wisconsin, Donald Trump gained 131 votes. As I said, 20,000 is a high hurdle. So he is acknowledging that, okay, you can do the recount. And again, if it's within the margin, which it looks like it's probably going to be, they get to do that. They just do. It's probably a waste of money that they won't pay, but they get to do that. It's probably not gonna flip 20,000 votes. If you have a legitimate recount. Now, if you get your lawyers in there and you find some way to take votes out this way over here and then that way over there, who knows? We'll have to see. The future of America, whether we have sort of the shambles of a democracy, or we don't even have that. That is what is going to be determined in the next few weeks.
That's what's on the ballot at this point, straight up. And again, seventh time today, this is what they were planning to do. This is the playbook. Yeah. We've seen it. We already know where we know the next play is going to be a toss sweep left. And the play after that is a deep slant. We've seen the playbook. We know where you're going.
Wow. You know, I'm just seeing this for the first time really fast. Democrats apparently flipped Michigan's Supreme Court by gaining a seat there and defending another. That's pretty awesome. If you're an international viewer, you're probably saying, wait, what are you talking about? Like they like ran for office for the Supreme Court. Yeah, we do that. I guess that's a thing that we do in some places. But anyway, they also gained a seat on the Ohio Supreme Court. They needed 2 to flip it. Now it's going to be 4-3 GOP advantage. Back in 2017, it was 7-0. Jesus. For more political news, breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is so you don't miss anything.